Hello, 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 and welcome. Welcome to All Together Now. I'm your host for this evening, Bobbie Steinbach, and we are so glad that you've joined us. Please just let us know where you're watching from in the comments. We know we have people from around the world. Tonight, we want to give a special welcome to those of you watching at Boston Hope Medical Center, the hospital just built at the convention center for people recovering from COVID-19. We're with you, and we're so glad you're with us. Today is the last day of National Poetry Month, and I'd like to start this evening with a very special Derek Walcott poem, Love After Love. The time will come when, with elation, you will greet yourself arriving at your own door, in your own mirror, and each will smile at the other's welcome and say, sit here, eat. You will love again the stranger who was yourself. Give wine, give bread, give back your heart to itself, to the stranger who has loved you all your life, whom you ignored for another, who knows you by heart. Take down the book, the love letters from the bookshelf, the photographs, the desperate notes, peel your own image from the mirror. Sit, feast on your life. Derek Walcott. Well, tonight's show, we have a biggie for you. So excited about the folks we have on tonight. First of all, we have a video postcard from Dublin and Los Angeles. Chloe Agnew and Mary B have created something wonderful. And Chloe is here to talk with us about it. And as it is the last day of National Poetry Month, we invited literary performer Regie Gibson, the former National Poetry Slam individual champion, to join us. And finally, my friends Charlie Beck and Charmaine Slavin, also known as Squirrel Butter, have two songs that will surely get your toes a-tapping. Our first guests this evening are Chloe Agnew and Mary B. Now, viewers may know Chloe as one of the original members and the youngest member of the cast of the PBS show Celtic Woman. Mary B has been working most recently on a docuseries called Finding Harmony. Welcome, Chloe. A delight to have you, Chloe. Where are you joining us from?
I'm here in my family home in Dublin in Ireland. I have been based in America for the last 7 years. I got my green card and I've been based out of Los Angeles and between Nashville and Georgia working a lot. But I'm based here. I'm at home here in with family in Ireland and thankful to be sitting this crazy time out with loved ones.
Yes, yes. Those of us who are spending time with family are most grateful and most fortunate. And how are you spending your time other than hanging out with your family these days?
Well, it's funny. It's come in waves with me. And the more honest I am about it, the more I realize I'm not alone. you know, I think for me, when the plug was pulled on Celtic Woman, it was a huge shock to the system. I was out on tour with an 85-city tour this whole spring. And it did really come to a shock to the system when I had to come home here and everything stopped. And so I've had days of productivity where I get up and I want to clean the whole house and I'm really productive. And then I've days too where I'm really uncertain and anxious and I kind of don't want to get out of bed. And, you know, so I have to say it's been the one blessing is being in a safe haven like this at home that I can be with loved ones right now. But it's been lovely also to use this time now that I am taking the productive days to get up and do the things that I never have time to do. You know, I've been doing a bit more art, some sketching, doing a lot of songwriting, working on my terrible, terrible guitar playing and having some quality time with family. It's been really lovely.
I think you speak for most of us because I think we're all finding ways in which we can be productive, ways in which we can forgive ourselves not being productive. And
You know, I think everybody reacts to these things in different ways, but it has really been amazing to me to see how people have really come together. It has been a great time of unity too, of that. I'm amazed at how creative people have been, how inventive they are at home right now. You know, being at home here in Ireland, I've been doing a lot of recording online. Mm. I've been doing a lot of songwriting sessions online. Myself and my sister have been doing a lot of fun things like online yoga sessions. We did a paint and sip class, which is really fun. We did art while we sipped Prosecco. And so there's, you know, people are being really inventive right now with what they can offer online to people while we're at home. And I think it's been incredible to see. And if we can do anything right now to provide a little bit of music as performers sitting at home, that's our job done.
I love the paint and sip with Prosecco. I think from now on, we're going to do All Together Now and chug. What do you think?
Yes, girl. Yes. I'm here for it. I'm ready for it. I've got the wine ready. Let's go.
Well, I know you and Mary have made something wonderful for us to watch. So let's watch Chloe and Mary's video. Hmm? Oh, would you like to talk about that?
We decided to do this little song because right for now, it's a time when I think words like this, it's an oldie, but it's a goodie. And it's one of those songs that you want to sing along to when you hear it. And I think the words are really appropriate right for now, that people are rallying together and we need to do so in the times that we're in right now. So I love Mary. I have all the time in the world for her. She's the most fantastic girl, a true supporter of other artists and a wonderful artist in her own right, as you know, from her series, Finding Harmony. So I'm thrilled that she joined me on this, and that the power of music, you know, we can be in two totally different places in the world, but we can come together and sing a song like this in times that we need it. So hope you all enjoy it.
Problem. you need a friend, call me, call me, call me, call me.
Mary B. and Chloe Agnew singing a gorgeous Lean on Me by Bill Withers. What a wonderful collaboration.
Oh, thank you. An absolute pleasure to make music with that beautiful voice. And what a great song, too. Mm-hmm. Appropriate for the times we're in.
Indeed. So, Chloe, I'm going to lean on you from now on. So we'll have to private message after the show.
Call me anytime, girl. Anytime you need a friend.
That was just, it's such a powerful and meaningful song. How did you and Mary find each other originally?
Funny enough, how the world works. We met each other in Los Angeles many years back now at this stage through a songwriter's singer's workshop and just hit it off straight away. I have all the time in the world for her, a very special human. And we got to make some music together and just glad our paths crossed. And so glad that we can continue to be in two different places of the world and make music this way together. How lovely that was. You know, it's the power of technology. And here we are. Thank you so much for giving us an opportunity to do this today and you know, to all your viewers and all that you guys do. Continued power to you, because we need a little bit of light and goodwill in the world right now, and something to put a smile on our face.
Thank you so much, Chloe and Mary, for joining us and sharing your music. It's been a great pleasure. You take care.
All the best.
Our next guest is the literary performer, Regie Gibson. And I want to let Kurt Vonnegut introduce him. Regie, when you perform, you are supersonic and in the stratosphere. You sing and chant for all of us. Nobody gets left out. Wow. Welcome, Regie. Well, thank you for joining us. And would you be... tell us a little bit about how you arrived at that description of your work, literary performance.
Yes. Well, I love literature and I love performing. And what I used to call myself strictly was a poet, which was a little bit narrow, I guess, after I started to really travel throughout the world and read more and see what's going on with literature and the way to present it. I was like, I think literary performer is what it is that I want to strive to be. And for me, that's a person who finds what is poetic and what is the beautiful thing in literature that pulls people to it and finds a way to perform it in such a way that people have a profound experience. So for me, I find poetry to be in all of those things that make people lean in just a little bit closer to what's being said or what it is they're reading. That to me is the poetic moment, and it doesn't need to just strictly be contained in what we call poetry.
And I know you have a profound connection to Shakespeare. Yes. Can you want to talk about that?
Sure. William Shakespeare, Willie Shakes, as I like to call him sometimes, has been a constant companion of mine since I was about 13 years of age. And my mother brought home a box of books, and inside that box of books was the complete works of William Shakespeare. And being about 13 years old, the only thing I knew was Romeo and Juliet. And so I read it, found it was great. I knew what it was, but I didn't really understand a lot, but I knew there was a lot going on. And when it really hit me is when I saw production of it, the Franco Zeffirelli version of Romeo and Juliet, starring Olivia Hussey and Leonard Whiting. And I was taken away, transported by the use of language that was also mixed with countenance and narrowing of the eyes and tone and movement. And from that moment on, I felt a connection to William Shakespeare's work, and I've dived into it ever since.
And you have a hip-hop Shakespeare?
I do. I do. I have a group we're called Shakespeare to Hip Hop. And we perform something called the Shakespeare Time Traveling Speakeasy, which is a production where we use live music, funk, jazz, blues, disco, country, gospel, show tunes to present background, history, and context for William Shakespeare's work. And plus, we also do William Shakespeare's work is also part of this. And it's always a great romp just to see people open up to what the bard has to give us.
I know it's really, really difficult to choose one play from the canon, but I think as you get older, your likes and dislikes evolve. Yeah. What is the trajectory of how you look at the canon and what are your favorite plays?
Sure. For me, my evolution, it would go like this. The first, it was Romeo and Juliet. It spoke to where I was. As I got older, as a teenager, moving into my late teens, early 20s, Hamlet began to really speak to me. And then after that, moving into my 30s, Macbeth began to speak to me. And now that I am a gentleman of a certain age, King Lear is really talking to me, but I also go back to Othello. I love Henry V, and part of that is because, you know, he's a leader, but he's also a very compromised individual, and he's had to compromise in order to get something done. And he was also, I think it's because he was a young man who was counted out because of some mistakes that he had made in the past. And then when the moment of truth came, he was able to show himself brave and show that he had in him all the time what he probably knew was there, but what everyone else doubted.
Mm, that's a beautiful analysis. I love that. Regie, can you tell us about the piece you're going to share with us tonight?
Certainly. It is a philosophical piece in the sense that it's a piece about questioning and the huge questions that we go through as human beings trying to inhabit this planet. And for me, it's part song, it's part poem. I use a looper, which is a device that loops my voice and allows me, a person who is not really a musician, to actually create some musical overlays. So hopefully I can sync that up and we can do that. You will hear a couple of Greek words in here, Eros and Thanatos. Well, it's about Eros and Thanatos because it's about love and death, which is what Shakespeare always talked about. Somebody, you know, love and death was the things he always went back to. And I find that those are things we human beings also go back to. So this is a piece for us, the 7-point-something billion of us inhabiting this planet moving throughout space.
Can't wait to hear it. Regie Gibson.
Sure. Here we go. Boom, beep, boom, beep, boom, beep, ba-doom, beep, beep, boom, beep, boom, beep, boom, beep, ba-doom, beep, boom. Short-lived hominids hanging about, doing our best just to figure it out. I said, here we are in a sea of stars somewhere between Venus and Mars. Short-lived hominids hanging about, doing our best just to figure it out. Where do we come from? Where do we go? What does it mean to question? What does it mean to know? What is this thing we've all deemed as a reality? Is it real or just an imagined fallacy that we've invented from our collective human senses? Is this world merely a screen upon which shadows are beamed as they radiate, emanating from a light screen from behind us? Why does space and time seem to confine us? I mean, is there more to us, or are we all just intelligible dust floating in this vat of galactic blackness? Does anybody, does anybody really know what the fact is? I mean, is there a being listening to this prayer? Or are we all alone and there's nothing there? I don't know the math, but I know somehow. One life plus two short equals live your life now. 'Cause here we are in a sea of stars. somewhere between Venus and Mars. Short-lived hominids hanging about, just doing our best to figure it out. I said, here we are in a sea of stars, somewhere between Venus and Mars. Short-lived hominids hanging about, just doing our best to figure it out. Aristotle, Plato, Zeno, and Parmenides, Epicurus, Augustine, Sartre, and Socrates, Bodhidharma, Gautama, Kant, and Protagoras, Kierkegaard, Hegel, Emerson, and Pythagoras, all of them relentlessly questioned dimensions that make up the makeup of human existence, the manic and the madness, the panic and the sadness, the inner and the outness, the how to be withoutness. The Greeks called us Thanatoi, y'all, meaning our lives are so brief, we might as well not live at all. But isn't that part of what beauty we possess? The fact that we're born in this flesh means that we're all destined for death, and that we're all just borrowing breath that'll pass to another as soon as we've left. The only moments we know we have for sure are what the fates allow. Life is lived quick, so we better live now. Here we are in a sea of stars, somewhere between Venus and Mars. Short-lived hominids hanging about, doing our best to figure it out. I said, here we are in a sea of stars, somewhere between Venus and Mars. Short-lived hominids hanging about, doing our best to figure it out. Just trying to figure it out. Trying to figure it out. To figure it out.
Thank you. Oh.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you. What a wordsmith. What a wordsmith.
Just trying to figure it out.
That was just trying to figure it out. Well, I think you've come a long way towards figuring it out.
Thank you.
That was Here We Are in a Sea of Stars. And Regie, I'm looking at all your books and with all the allusions in your song, it seems like you probably read them all.
Oh yeah. I've read, but all those behind me have been read. There are others which you know, I'm getting to. And luckily, people often send me books because they know that it's one of my favorite things to receive. So I always have a pile of books. And I like to say that no matter how well read we may be, we're all woefully underread, right? There's always another thing we need to read. There's another thing we need to check out, another something that we need to bring inside of us to help us discover what it means to be this curious species, you know, on this planet right now, just trying to do our best to figure out what's going on, you know?
You bet. Listen, I wonder if you could talk a little bit about the link, which will show at the end, to support Beyond Classical Theater, the cause, which is currently raising funds in honor of our dear friend and your mentor, Johnny Lee Davenport.
Yes. Thank you, Bobby, for giving me the chance to speak about this. Johnny Lee Davenport was a Boston icon. He was a person who was an actor, and he was fiercely, fiercely intelligent and a very loving individual. And he performed a lot of Shakespeare's work. And what he wanted was to have more of an opportunity for people of color to get into Shakespeare's work and perform that. And so what he did was he wanted to start this forum, which was called Beyond Classical Theater, but he never got the chance to do it because, unfortunately, he died very recently, and he was on his last play. He was about to perform in August Wilson's Fences, which was going to be a very fitting end to his acting career, and he wanted to devote himself into teaching and to mentoring others, and he never got the chance to start this organization. So his wife, Kelly Cook, she started it with some friends, and now they're in the process of raising money for it. They need $15,000 to establish this firm firmly, and they're about at $9,100. So anyone mm-hmm. out there who would love to donate to this, I'm sure that it would be very, very greatly appreciated. And it would be an honor of an individual who has done so much for the art scene. I always tell people, if you don't know who Johnny Lee Davenport is, you have no idea how impoverished your life is. Find out who he is, understand, and please donate if you can.
Yes, please do. I have one of my favorite memories of Johnny Lee. We did a number of Shakespeare's mm-hmm. plays together, and when we were doing Pericles, we were dance partners. Mm-hmm. Now, you know, Johnny was about 6'5" yeah. and a big bear of a yeah. man, and of course, I'm a tiny little person, and I just always, we used to laugh about it, but I always just felt enveloped by his the immensity of his love and his spirit. It was a gift, a real gift. Mm-hmm. He was a man of the spirit, a man of the earth, just, and of words, like you, Regie. Oh, and I can see that you and Johnny have a lot in common too. Thank you so much for joining
Absolutely.
Us. It's been a
Thank
true
you for
pleasure,
having you, Bobbie. I appreciate it. And thanks for what you're doing.
Thank you. Take care. Well, to close the show this evening, we are delighted to have a video postcard from Squirrel Butter. Squirrel Butter, what a name! I worked with them this past winter in Christmas Revels. And well, they are just consummate, fun, amazing musicians. Charlie Beck and Charmaine Slavin. They play between them just so many instruments. It's mind-boggling. Banjo, guitar, fiddle, steel guitar, and they also step dance and sing in really pretty amazing harmonies. Thank you so much, Charlie and Charmaine, and welcome.
Hi, Bobbie.
Hello, our pleasure.
Thank you for having us.
It's so nice to have you. Where are you? Excuse me, where are you coming from this evening?
We are screening in from Seattle, Washington.
And I bet it's sunny there today.
Well, it was, but it's not anymore.
Yep, the clouds have moved in.
Well, yes. I think we switched. We switched because we had a cloudy, rainy day, and now at the end of the day, the sun came out, so that was kind of nice.
Coastal flip-flop.
You have a little friend at home who's napping, right?
It's true.
We have her on our baby monitor right now. She's still napping.
Yes, and Hazel is our 2-year-old daughter.
It's working out so far.
Excellent.
You never know.
Do you sing her?
Yes, any nap we get
is
great.
Do you sing her to sleep?
What? I do sing her to sleep. Yep, she has her favorite songs. She's very demanding about specific lyric requests. And
yeah, if you do it wrong, she'll wake up and reprimand you.
Yeah,
so that works against you.
Yeah, she's a good manager.
You know, we are thrilled to have you, and I know that you have a video postcard for us. And before we watch, I'd love to hear a bit about your music and the traditions that influenced you.
Yeah, well, we love old music, and we listen to a lot of recordings from the 1920s, 1930s of early American music. And most of it's stuff from the Southeast United States and Appalachia and that region. And we love old fiddle tunes and old songs. And that's exactly what's on the video postcards, a couple of traditional tunes that we picked out for you all. And the first one's called If I Fall. And the second one is called Love Will Roll the Clouds Away. Mm-hmm. And we learned this music through our community. I stumbled upon a festival in 2005 called the Portland Old Time Gathering. And that's where I met this wonderful gentleman, Charlie Beck. And he was playing music there that year. And I hadn't started playing music yet, but everything I saw at that festival really inspired me to get started. So I picked up the guitar and started flat footing and learned fiddle a little bit later. and started singing songs. And Charlie here, he was a street performer at the time in Seattle. So I found that out about him and asked if I could tag along with him to the Pike Place Market, where I would practice my flat footing. And so that's how I got a lot better at dancing. And then I started playing music with Charlie too on the guitar and singing songs together. And I feel really lucky to have come across that event. It was an inspiring thing in my life.
Wow, of course it was. My goodness. I it's interesting. We've had a number of artists on who have started late in life to come to music or come to poetry.
Never too
late. No, it isn't. Well, we're going to watch Squirrel Butter's video now and listen to If I Fall in Love, We'll Roll the Clouds Away and see some flat footing.
Cheeping. Well, that was one of our little baby chicks back here.
We're raising baby chicks on the old piano. We're trying to get them used to this old-time music.
Yeah, here.
Oh. Oh. That's sweet. It's our newest addition to the band. Get in there. Get in there and tune up,
yep.
Chicks.
We got four little babies back there, so you hear the peeping. That's what's going on. All right, this one's an old gospel song called I Will Love, or Love Will Roll the Clouds Away.
Yes, I will love this song. Yes. All right, here we go.
Message of that song, and hope you do too.
Oh, wonderful. Thank you. That was Squirrel Butter and their adorable baby chicks with If I Fall and Love Will Roll the Clouds Away, and they certainly will. And that was some, what is it, Flat Footing. I love that. That was fantastic. I remember watching you folks every night in Christmas revels and just being filled with joy and just seeing this video. Just brought all that back to me. Thank you so much. Now, I know we will hear from people if I don't ask, how did you get the name Squirrel Butter?
Oh, yes. Yeah, good question. Charmaine, you want to field this?
Well, Charlie is largely responsible for the name. We had just moved in together, and Charlie was horribly sick and had a fever. And woke up in the middle of the night and rolled over and said, I know what we should name our duo. Squirrel Butter. And I just felt so bad for him, I couldn't say no. So I agreed. And the next week we had business cards and a website, and there's no going back.
Yeah. We had regrets, but we're like, we've already put in $70 worth of business cards.
After
stickers.
About a month, we were like, was this a good
idea?
We
can't afford to change our name right now. So we're stuck with it.
It's a great name. It's just a great, great name. Because, you know, of course.
Turns out it's hard to forget. So
it is.
That's a good thing we've got going for us.
Very sticky.
It is.
Very sticky.
Well, it's just Charmaine and Charlie. Thank you so, so much for sharing your
music
with us tonight. And hope to see you again. Really, really soon. I missed you guys. It's so good to see you.
Aww.
Miss you too.
Miss you too. Big hugs and big thanks to the staff that's also helping produce this wonderful program. I know there's a lot of great minds behind keeping this show on the air, so to speak. So.
Yes.
Thanks, everyone.
Thank you. Love you. Bye. Oh, my goodness. We have links to these just terrific artists so that you can support them and support their work. And that support is so crucial right now. Thank you again to Squirrel Butter and to Regie Gibson and Chloe Agnew and Mary B. And to all of you for joining us tonight. And if you would like to see more from All Together Now, just follow, like, and subscribe to us. We're on Facebook, YouTube, and Twitch. And oh, by the way, you can check out our past shows. If you miss, for instance, Livingston Taylor on show one, or Buman on show four, or the hysterical Paula Plum and Richard Snee on show seven, you can find them. Yes, you can. They're still up. So please check them out. We will be back on Tuesday next week with a video postcard from pianist Tulani Marks in South Africa. Dear Tulani. And Igor Goliak and Daria Denisova, Arlequin Players Theater, and the groundbreaking band Arc Iris. Now, you can't see them at Oberon or Poisson Rouge, but you can see them at All Together Now. Until then, for everyone listening, and especially for everyone recovering from COVID-19 at Boston Hope, keep a song in your heart. And as our good friend Johnny Lee Davenport always said, hold a good thought. Good night.